Hi everyone, this is Aditi from Concurate and I'm here with you for a story from sales, marketing, business, whatever you want to call it. And today we are going to learn how Lego pulled out itself from an $800 million debt, and within almost a decade, they were boasting profits of $600 million. Isn't this a Herculean task or a great transformation which we all must look into? So, I will keep the story of bankruptcy for another day. Today, I will tell you how they rose from that almost bankruptcy state and, you know, pulled themselves together, pivoted their business and became this world recognized brand. After that bankruptcy in 2003, Lego thought maybe innovations is the way to take forward. They came up with this toy which was like only few pieces and kids could build it in few minutes and get going. This was called like Jackstone. I think maybe this idea popped because of the popularity of toys like Barbie and other figurines, but that failed. That idea failed. Wondering why? I will tell you a secret today. Parents would want, you know, a peaceful Sunday afternoon. Now, for that peaceful Sunday afternoon, they would want their children to be engaged in something productive and not really watching TV for 2-3 hours. So Lego is a kind of toy which can keep children busy for hours because kids keep following the instructions, keep building the sets. That is like the minimum time it takes to make, you know, a decent sized toy. Now, that was not happening with this. Next experiment they tried was coming up with toys that had inbuilt electronics, accompanied video game. And this figure was actually from a movie, Galidor. Now, before Galidor, Lego had, you know, done another movie or, you know, built toys based on another movie called Bionicle. That was a huge hit. However, this movie they tried making themselves, and even though they did a great work with marketing, you know, they created a TV show around that whole toy campaign. They made it electronic for children to play or get more engagement. They even created an accompanying video game. They tried giving it in, you know, these Happy Meal boxes at McDonald's. They must have burned a lot of marketing dollars in this, and even then the toy was not well received. Now, from the stories that I read, the failure is, you know, the reason was for the failure was the TV show was a flop. It didn't do well. The fun of building Lego or building sets with Lego was missing. Then the timing was not right. So many, many things led to the failure. And then they almost went bankrupt. Why do you think they went bankrupt? Because they had lost the sight of who their target audience was. Parents were buying users. Were buyers and children were users. Parents were buying to keep their kids busy, and children, of course, they were the users, so for them it didn't really matter as much. However, they decided to, you know, go back to bricks and continue with their fire alarm sets or fire engine sets, etc. But still, they needed a bigger recap. And ultimately, they decided to, you know, look into some unheard signals. So they were receiving fans from adult males, but they were not responding because in that era, adults playing with toys was considered shameful, or adults were mocked at for playing with toys. So they didn't really pay any attention because the marketing budgets were cut, advertising budgets were cut. They didn't really have more money to fuel their business. They thought maybe they should take one look at what these adult fans had to say. By the way, AFOL is adult fan of Lego. And you know, when they found out that a lot of adults were holding unofficial fan conventions around the world for Lego, and they had online communities you know, where they were interacting about their Lego sets and what they built, etc., Lego actually discovered this new love, which was actually a little old. Just that it was a late discovery. And when they identified that there are adults who are, you know, Lego fans, they thought they need to make it huge and remove the taboo that adults shouldn't play toys or they should feel embarrassed to enjoy toys. To removing that taboo, they conducted huge scale conventions where they had millions of bricks for adults to come around and, you know, create things, showcase what their imagination is, etc. Lego also engaged with renowned players who also had that love for Lego, and they could become the brand ambassadors for Lego, like David Beckham. Third thing that Lego did was to change the messaging. Now, instead of saying that it's a joy for 7 to 12 years old, endless fun, not just for kids, unleash your inner child today. Unleash your inner child today. Adults are nothing but tall kids. When they identified that adults were enjoying like this, they were able to remove the taboo, they actually found a lot many more opportunities to cater to this adult audience. These adult fans came from, you know, multi-dimensional skill set. There were architects, there were software engineers, there were marketing people, and they were basically creative minds which Lego could leverage to think of future possibilities. And from there, the idea came. Now, listen carefully, okay? This is the biggest takeaway from this video. To crowdsource the ideas from the people who are going to use your product. That way, you are not doing a hit and trial that you are making something, giving people to try. No, the idea is coming from the people who are going to buy from you. This was an amazing move, and this was the way that helped Lego rise up again like a phoenix. And the best part is, whoa, looks like I'm the dinosaur here. The best part was they created a system around this whole concept of bringing ideas from the customers. Ideas.lego.com is the portal where creators can submit product ideas, and if they get enough support, like if they get 10,000 supporters, Lego takes it to commercial level after an expert view. Building a community is like a no-brainer for many businesses, but not everybody is able to create a community that thrives, that engages very well with you and the fellow members of the community. So for that, they also hold contests and activities, and Lego has just nailed it with this system of theirs, where Lego completely changed the way it looked at its adult fans. And honestly, these adult fans only helped it survive and thrive later. One of the key persons at Lego, Mr. Mackie, says Lego used to treat their adult customers like commodity. Today, they treat them like part. So what is the lesson we take away from here? The lesson is, in our businesses, we need to be really, really cautious about what our customers really want. And instead of doing the guesswork, conducting buyer interviews or surveys or any which way you can learn more about them to connect the data points, the stronger strategy you'll be able to create around your business. If you like this story and you would like to hear more such stories around sales, marketing, business, do follow us on Concurate. Have a good day, good night, see you, bye-bye.